I'm Dr. V. Srikanth Reddy, working as a consultant surgical oncologist at Fortis Cancer Institute, Bangalore. So, as a part of Breast Cancer Awareness Month, our NGO Samrohana and Oncostim Diagnostics have taken this initiative to start this awareness campaign. And this campaign is mainly oriented towards the patients. And we've divided this campaign into two sessions. The first session is going to be today. And in the first session, we are discussing about cancer awareness, screening, and breast cancer symptoms. And the second session will be the following Sunday at the same time, where we'll be talking about the topics related to breast cancer management. So these are the two sessions. So today, along with me, I have my panel members, Dr. Sandeep Nayak, consultant surgical oncologist and head at Fortis Cancer Institute, Bangalore, and Max Clinic, Jayanagar. Dr. Suresh Babu is a medical oncologist and he works at Kidwai Institute and Fortis Cancer Institute as well. And Meghna Muskan is our cancer genetic counselor. And Swati Mukund, she is a Pinkathon ambassador and Instagram influencer. And we also have Dr. Arunima, she is a tobacco cessation specialist. So today's session we have divided into two main parts. The first part, Dr. Sandeep Nayak will give key tips to the participants about how to reduce the cancer risk, followed by a panel session where we'll be discussing the common questions, what generally we generally see during our OPD times, what patients ask. So Dr. Sandeep, you can take the call and start your talk.
Thank you very much and very good morning. Okay, so here we are. So thanks for everyone for joining this program. So today, as Dr. Srikanth said, we will be covering the aspects of breast cancer prevention. So in my first presentation, I'll talk about the key tips to identify breast cancer early enough. So, and then we'll be following it with the other topic of, in the panel discussion, we'll be talking about the risk reduction and such kind of things which are important for you to understand, for everyone to understand. So it's a very stepwise approach and it's a 1 hour program that we are intending to do. Now, what are the key steps? Before we understand the key steps, common is something which I thought I should address, and we should understand this, then only we should proceed. Now, if you look at this graph, this is from 2004 to 2020. These were little, predicted ones with now based on the data which is available. Look at the graph, it is continuously growing up. So that means, the incidence of cancer has been increasing over the years, and in this short time of about 15-20 years, we have seen a significant rise in the number of patients who get cancer. So that is a very, very important reason why we should be aware of what is happening and how we can prevent and or how we can escape as much as possible. Now, why has this happened? It is very important to understand that nothing magical really has happened. I'll just go behind and show you what is the real reason. See, if you see this in 1950s, our life expectancy was somewhere around 37. This is India's curve. Around 37 years was our average life expectancy. So that means, by the time this year, all of us would have been dead. Most of us who are in this panel would be dead. I don't know, maybe with some few exception, at least I would have been dead by now. So so this is, but over time, what has happened is, life expectancy improved. So as of now, we are looking at around 70 years in India as well. So we have seen a change in the trend or the change in the life expectancy which has happened over this time. And what is the result? Why did that happen? It happened because we were able to reduce the deaths due to infectious diseases. That is the cause. Like, you know, very few cases of deaths due to tuberculosis or things like typhoid or pneumonia, these things have, you know, become lesser reasons to die now. So because of that, what happened was these diseases which were non-infectious, means, you know, not due to infection, like which are due to lifestyle or because of other issues which come up, became the causes of death. And thus, as you eliminate one cause, your life expectancy also increased. So today, the main of the reduction in the number of infectious diseases that happened over this century, over the 20th century, the entire life expectancy scenario changed. So that is why you are seeing, you know, that, you know, we are living longer, we have a better expectancy, and only things, most of the things that are left behind, which actually leads to death, is today heart diseases, cancer, and such non-infectious causes, the causes which are not due to infection. So that is why we are, you know, living longer today. Now, what is the entire problem with living longer? The basic thing about living longer is, as your body gets older, there is a continuous damage that accumulates. The accumulation of damage, just like a old car, as you have a car, you keep it for 10 years, 15 years, the damages that have accumulated starts manifesting as it gets older. Same way, our body also starts accumulating damages as we get older, and those damages start accumulating in our body, the DNA damages, the various other damages that occur, and that leads to the problem. See, you know, as a, you know, usually we say the cutoff is about 40 years. So damages build up around 40 years, and after 40 years of age, we start seeing various diseases cropping up. See, heart diseases, cancers. Cancers can come after the age of 40. So it starts growing up, and as you get older, the risk of cancers gradually keeps increasing. So, and other diseases also are pointed out here, heart diseases, stroke, Alzheimer's disease, all these diseases increase as you get older. So this is the reason why we are seeing more cancers today. So what we have understood from this presentation is age is a very important and unavoidable risk factors. Whatever we do, we will get old. Whatever we do, we are temporary on this earth. So we have to accept that. What we can do is we can reduce the risk by, or we can look at reducing the risk and to, you know, improve our outcomes when we have these diseases. Now, you know, without comparing with corona, no presentation today is considered complete. See, this is the data which I picked up from the presentation or research paper, which was published for the during the peak of corona outbreak in the United States. So that is between February and May. And when you compare the data of, deaths compared to cancer and heart diseases, more cancers killed, you know, the deaths due to cancer and heart disease were much more compared to corona deaths. So even though it's an infectious disease, it has added to the number of deaths, but it has not yet overtaken by the incidence within that particular time span. So it has not done that. So still the major killers are heart diseases and cancer. So that we need to really remember. And so that is the importance of looking at cancer as a, you know, very important factor when we look at awareness and education. What is the Indian breast cancer scenario today? In fact, if you look at this, the change in trend, you know, in the 80s and 90s, if you see, cervical cancer was very common cancer, but the trend has changed. And today, if you see, the breast cancer has become the most common cancer. And that is why the emphasis on breast cancer awareness has been made. Now, what is happening actually, you know, this graph also talks a lot. See, this is what is the annual percentage change, means, you know, every year, what is the change in the percentage of breast cancer that we are seeing? And look at this, you know, across India, many states, many cities, if you see, there is an increase. We are not seeing any decrease in the incidence of breast cancer. Year on year, it has only increased. So, you know, in Bangalore, it is about 3.1% increase annually. Every year, there is a number, you know, increase in the number. So that is also a big concern. And why awareness and screening is important is because we are looking at, you know, this is this, you know, this is what happens when, you know, this is the data of patients who come to the hospital and what is their stage when they come to us. And if you look at this, 57%, that is about 60% of the people reach us at, you know, in the stage three. Loco-regional disease means a stage three disease. This is stage one and two, where the outcomes are far better. But in stage three, the outcomes are not as great. So, but, you know, unfortunately, most of the patients, 60% of the patients reach us in stage three. And all our effort is to bring this these people to come to us in locally, you know, local disease, that is stage one and two, where the outcomes would be far better. In when we talk about this stage, the this stage, the, you know, in stage three, the, you know, approximately 50% of the patients will have recurrence. That is a concern. So this is another way of looking at it. You know, we our peak in India, you know, when we when do we see cancers in India, breast cancers? It's around 45 to 50 years of age is the maximum peak. And unfortunately, you know, it is compared to Western data, it is little earlier than them. And that is a concern because this is the age group which has a very important role to play in the society. They are responsible for their children at that age. They are responsible. They are working. Many of them are working. And so with all these concerns, this becomes a very important age group. So our peak is around 45 to 50 years, though the incidence is still there, but our incidences are not as great when the patient is older. Now, we need to look at awareness at in two aspects. One is to reduce the risk of cancer, which we'll be discussing in our panel as well. We need to look at how to detect the cancer very early, which is the main topic in my presentation. So I'll be talking about the aspects which are very important to be known, understood when it comes to detection early. We will deal with the risk reduction in our panel discussion. What is the importance of early detection? If you see this, this is an accident, scenario of an accident. So whenever there is an accident, there is something called a golden hour. Golden hour is the time when if a help reaches the person in the accident, that life can be saved. So the idea of cancer care is also similar. When we detect the cancer early, we can most of the times get exceptionally good results. Look at this, you know, when usual care, which is, you know, when the patient finds the disease, waits for longer time to till, you know, there is some diagnosis and then comes to the doctor, gets a diagnosis, the life expectancy is much lower than when it is detected early enough. The patient herself notes some small lump and comes and then detects, and then the treatment is in, you know, started, and then we have a, you know, cure. The life expectancy, the expected life is little shorter than when we look at the screen detector. Screen detected is even before the symptom starts. Patient goes for a mammography, some very tiny thing is detected, and that patient comes to us for treatment. That case, the scenario is far, far better. You know, the likelihood of a cure is far, far better, which means it is always, it is far superior to identify the, you know, cancer by screening, by mammography, than by, a, you know, observing a lump in the breast, than waiting for a doctor to diagnose it after it becomes very big. So you have to remember, the earlier the diagnosis, it is better the outcome. So the diagnosis should happen before the first symptoms appear. In breast cancer, the first symptom that you notice is actually a breast lump. So if the diagnosis happens before that, that is the best. But it does not happen most of the cases. The outcomes are still good, but it does not happen in most of the cases. And that is why we suggest that, you know, you should do breast self-examination. Still, the outcomes are far better, remember. So why early diagnosis? The treatment of an early diagnosed cancer is very simple. It is shorter. Very often we may be able to even avoid chemotherapy and all the aggressive kinds of other treatments. We may be able to just do one form of treatment and get a cure for the patient. The deformities are less, which basically in a breast cancer, what is a deformity? There is, mastectomy. When the breast is removed, the patient has to live with the stigma of breast removal. So that can be avoided. Complications are less because it's a smaller disease, smaller surgery, complications are less. Like, you know, we can avoid if there are no lymph node spread, we don't have to do an aggressive lymph node dissection. So patient's outcome in the long run will be far, far better. The quick recovery, there is a quick recovery for the patient. Patients recover, go home faster, drains can be pulled out easier, much earlier, and high likelihood of cure. In fact, the early detected cancers, the cure rate can be nearly 100%. That is the beauty of it. So how can we do this? We have three main arrows for this. That is self-examination, doctor's examination, and mammography. And these three define the most important things for, these are the mantras of early detection. Now, what do we do in this? You know, I was actually, when I planned this program, I was told, you know, I should talk extensively on self breast examination. And I have kept a few slides for this. Self breast examination is, you know, has three steps, three main steps. One is the inspection, that is looking in, standing in front of the mirror and looking at the breast. Step two is lying down and feeling the breast. Palpation in medical terms is feeling. And then standing or sitting position, feeling the breast. These are the three important steps. So what do you look for? You basically stand in front of the mirror, look at the way the two breasts are compared to each other. You look at any changes that you have seen. So you look at the, in front of the mirror, you look for any dimpling, you look for any other changes that have happened from the last time that you examined the breast. Look from side to side. Look at the armpits. Do you see any bumps? Do you see any swelling? Is there a shape change? Is the nipple pulled up? These are the same things which you look at every time. See, you know, there is no, you're not looking at a diagnosis. You're only looking at a change in the breast. Okay, you are looking at how the breast is appearing. You're not looking at, you know, you're not sitting there to diagnose. Once you do that, you bend forward and look in the mirror. See if the in one of the breast is held back. Is it pulled up? Is it falling down normally on both sides? Once that is done, lift your arms up and see if there is any difference in the difference in the way the breasts are moving upwards. So these are three important things that you need to do when you look at your breast, right? So after that, you lie down on your back, keep a small pillow under your arm or under your back and feel the breast. You know, you can feel it from by one of these techniques. You can go in zigzag manner, you can go in a circular manner. Any one of these ways you can move your finger, and you should use the palm of your finger, not this area, but the tips of your finger, this area, not the palm, so that, you know, these are the most sensitive area of your hand. So use that and feel for any lumps in the breast. That is very important. Don't use this. You have to use this. So, and feel the left breast with, right hand and right breast with left hand, so that, you know, you get the feel of it. And then you stand up or sit up and feel the same way, same technique, and get, you know, you should have a feel of your breast. You should know how it feels, so that, you know, next time when you feel, if there is a change, you can always report it and come to a doctor. Now, okay, I'll show you a few more slides before I come to how frequently you should do it. There are frequency things as well. So I'll come to that. What are the important things you look for when you're looking? first of all, you have to look at the lump, if there is a swelling somewhere. Is there a pulled up nipple when you compare to the opposite side and compared to the last time? Is the nipple pulled up? Is a dimpling of the skin over some area because the tumor is pulling it inside? Is there any dripping? Means basically, is there a bleeding from the nipple? Is there any secretions from the nipple? This is very important to see. Is there a redness, rash around anywhere over the skin? Are there any skin changes like, you know, puckering of the skin, any form of skin change that you notice? So these are the main things which you notice, look for when you are inspecting or looking at the breast and feeling the breast. Remember, very important point which I keep stressing in every one of my talks, cancer is a painless disease. Don't expect pain in the beginning. So every patient who comes to me tells me there is no pain, doctor, so I sat over it. No, cancer is not a painful disease when it starts. It is a absolutely painless disease. So this is a video of self-examination which you can see. So what I have described till now is actually described in a similar way, but it is a video, so you'll be able to understand it better. Very important thing here is that, you know, you have to always examine the breast during ovulation. That's about 14 days from the time of your periods. Just feel your breast around that time. So that week, that is in the second or third week. Don't feel what is advisable for postmenopausal patients who have attained their menopause. What is advisable is fix a calendar date. So for first of a month or 15th of a month, fix a date and on that day only examine. This is very important because if you examine yourself every day, whatever you see every day, if you see a person every day, you can't make out whether that person has lost weight or not or gained weight. So you should look at it only once in a month so that you have a clear idea that what has changed. So that is important. And as we occurs around 14 days before your period, the previous period, okay, or the next period, sorry. So aim is, I have already discussed all these things, so you can just look at the video as you are going on. And one of the other recommendation has been is that, you know, you can take a selfie and compare it to next time, because this is a selfie error. You can always do that. So, you know, what you look for is also very clearly defined over here. Dimpling, redness, bulging, rashes, swelling, that is swelling of the entire breast, discharge from the nipple, or any change in the position of the nipple. So these are the important things. Raise your arm. I have already discussed this. Do the same thing with the arms by the side and pressing your, this one also, which I forgot to tell you, around the waist. Lying down, feeling of the breast. Look for anything. See, this is the way to feel with your, you know, fingertips you have to feel. So all the areas, systematically look at all the areas. Again, remember, all this is being done only once in a month, not every day. If you do it every day, you are more likely to miss all the findings. So in fact, what is also recommended in many places is feel during shower. So whatever is advised while standing to be done, standing can be done during, bath as well. So if you find anything, you should consult a doctor, and self-breast examination is not superior to mammography or doctor's examination. Remember that. So what is mammography? We are going to the more this thing. These are screening things. You know, what is mammography? Mammography is an X-ray. Breast is compressed like this and X-ray is taken. Sonomammography is ultrasound. Both are complementary. Many times we need both. So mammography is an X-ray study of the breast. This is how it comes. We look at the features which are there and this kind of dangerous features which you will not be able to identify. As doctors, even I may not be able to spot it many times, but the radiologists will be the people who will do it. And they'll identify these places, these areas which look suspicious, and such areas will be biopsied. And a disease which is so tiny will have much, much better result and outcome than compared to many others. Now, when to do? See, at the age of 20 years is when you are recommended to do breast self-examination on monthly basis. Any new symptoms, you need to consult the doctor. You should not hesitate from consulting doctors. 29 years to 39 years of age group, what is recommended is breast self-examination plus doctor's examination once in 3 years. So self-examination monthly and once in 3 years do a doctor's consultation. And once you are 40 and above, breast self-examination plus yearly doctor's examination and a regular mammography every 1 or 2 years is what is recommended, and that is what we recommend. So apart from you know, you can read all the things which I have written in this book. There is a detailed book which I have written, and this gives you all the idea about various cancers, and even breast cancer is completed in this. And you can go through the blog also. Our blog has a lot of articles on these various things which come up. So this book is actually free for download. You can easily download it from our website as well as from our OPDs. So this is as far as the presentation is concerned. I can also share one more thing, that is, you know, about, 1 second, I'm not able to get out of this. Yeah, I wanted to share what is Samrohana. Shall I do that also now only, Shrikant?
Yeah, sir.
Okay, so I'll just quickly go through what is Samrohana. Samrohana actually started off because of all our passion to do some service. Doing a lot of educational work over the years, but you know, we needed a platform to do it. We have been doing, me, Dr. Suresh, and many of us have been doing this over the years, but we needed a platform, and we thought, you know, we needed our own platform to do this. So these are the activities which I had done with Connect to Heal NGO, which, you know, and Dr. Suresh also has been doing many other activities. And many of us in the panel have been actively involved in various activities to create awareness. And this is the platform which we thought it would be very useful for, you know, creating awareness. The key idea of this platform is what I put it as CAPS. So CAPS stands for connecting people. We try to connect people who have gone through the same experience before, like people who have undergone breast cancer treatment. We connect with the younger patients. In fact, it has helped a lot of people to connect with each other and, you know, get the knowledge which the person who has already undergone and passed through the Agni Pariksha, literally. So, and they can share with each other. Awareness is a key thing. We do this, the A stands for awareness. We have, we do this kind of programs which are for the awareness of patients. Prevention is something which involves multiple things. It includes educational camps, tobacco cessation programs, screening programs, which have participated and have effectively done in many places. Support is something which comes when we look at, you know, counseling support for the patients using various counselors who are there with us. And also we look at, in future, we have ambition to support financially when feasible, because as of now, we are too young and too new. We don't have the ability to support, but we look at that. You can always visit our website, which is samrohana.com. We are going to activate donate as well as join us facilities very soon, and we look at, you know, long-term associations, and we look at how we can help the people. So this is how we can contact us, my secretary's number as well as the email ID for Samrohana. Thank you very much. Shrikant, over to you.